Okay, so hey, let's start laminating. In today's laminating session, we'll start by discussing the latest trends that we see driving the laminating business forward. After that, more about laminating complex products and what kind of technologies we have been developing to help glass processors with these kind of products. And in the end, we'll be sharing some news where we are with automating the whole flat laminating process. If we are looking at the laminated glass business, so first of all, laminated glass is one of the quickest growing product areas in the glass industry at the moment. The fundamental driver behind the growth is, of course, safety. So different regulations are requiring safer products, and different kinds of applications are just needing more and more safety all the time. At the same time, architects and designers are looking to increase transparency in buildings and in our surroundings, as well as making their designs more and more individual. Good examples of products that we are seeing more and more are, for example, structural laminates, where with a very thick and strong laminated unit, you can replace load-bearing structures such as pillars in buildings. What this means then in practice for the glass processor is that, first of all, you have to be able to deal with more and more complex products. And at the same time, individual projects are getting smaller and smaller. So production is becoming very mixed, and combining the wide product range with small series can often be a challenge. And this is what we have already been focusing on for a long time in our lamination development. And one particular area that we see growing very rapidly, especially in the past 2 to 3 years, is the usage of structural interlayers. And the growth started from these structural laminates, but these are now making their way more and more to the everyday products like windows and railings and so on. And when we go into the production of these challenging complex laminates, glass processors nowadays are often having to deal with slightly lower capacity, slightly fluctuating yield, which also often leads to slightly lower overall yield. And the knowledge requirement for operators is usually higher with these kind of products. And the thing behind all of these challenges is what we call narrow operating window. And what the narrow operating window then means in practice is that each kind of laminate, each product, has a certain optimal temperature that you want to heat it to. Based on the laminate complexity, there's a certain variation that how much higher or lower than this optimal temperature you can be and still achieve good quality. When you're in the, let's say, simple products, an example of this would be float PVB laminates in small sizes. So you have a huge window to play with. But then when you're increasing the complexity of the laminate, the window starts to decrease. And the complexity can be actually many things. It can be adding tempered glass in the mix. It can be the size of the laminate, the used interlayer, or, for example, making multi-layer structures. And now, let's take a quick trip to Finland, where Jussi Niemioja from our R&D will, first of all, show you an example that what kind of problems you can see when the quality issues are starting to show, and also what kind of technologies we have been developing to help glass processors with these challenges.
Here we have a typical pre-lamination example of a complex glass. And you can see that the center temperature and the edge temperature have been different. And that's why we get this very common trapped air problem. And this is basically not relevant on which technology you are running, but every time the same happens due to the physics. And now, in our case, we have been working with our customers, and we have seen it in many places with the old technologies and new technologies. And now we have been able to understand the behavior of these things behind this, and we have tried to provide a solutions for this. So next we're going to run a glass, which is being run with our latest convection technology. And this technology is built to tackle this issue. And the glass type will be 3x10 millimeters with 2 center films in between the glasses. So here we have the glass samples driven by this convection control system on. So what you can see that this on this bigger glass, the trailing edge area, you have much nicer result than here. The glass composition and the parameters are otherwise exactly the same. And this really gives the bigger processing window for the operators to succeed on these complex glasses.
So, as Jussi was explaining, what the newly developed convection control system does is that it opens up the operating window significantly on the complex end of laminates. The example that we saw was definitely from the very, very complex end. And normally you have to be very precise to achieve good quality with that kind of laminate. But with a convection control system processing even that kind of complex laminate is more like producing your everyday float PVB laminates. And this is now something that will be out very shortly for the glass processors. And it will help glass processors achieve higher capacity and higher yields with these complex laminates. And most importantly, it will make this production much, much easier for operators, as the machine will be able to take control of the process and the operators don't need so much knowledge to tackle certain issues and change the parameters. So this is something that's now out very soon and something that we are very, very happy to see out in the market and to help glass processors. Next, let's talk a bit about automating the whole laminating process. And before we go to what's the future of automation, let's have a look at what we already did with the ProWeld technology when we launched it 5 to 6 years ago. So if we are looking at the customer's production, you always have certain production mix that you're dealing with. It can be very mixed and wide, or it can be a bit simpler, but anyhow, you always have certain recipes and parameters that you need to get the quality in the end. And what glass processors traditionally have been struggling with is huge complexity of recipes and different settings. And if we look at how the glass flow would look like in a traditional laminating line, it would be something like this. So you would have a huge amount of recipes for all of your different products, all of your different coatings. And the parameters that you need to change really require knowledge from the operator, and often you are changing the heater firings, furnace temperature, and that of course means that whenever you want to do a product change, it leads to change over time. And this means that you're losing capacity, the process is not as stable as you would like it to be, which leads to lower yield, and you need always the very experienced operators to make the changes and then control the process. At the same time, you're actually using quite a lot of energy for making the products. And this complexity was what we initially wanted to tackle with the new ProWeld technology. And the end result of that development is that we eliminate the effect of the coating completely, thanks to the full convection technology that we're using. And the technology itself actually automates already a huge portion of the process. And most importantly, when you're running your normal products, you're always running with the same furnace temperature. And this always means that the process is, of course, very stable, and product changeovers are extremely quickly. So you're getting higher capacity out of the line, you're getting more stable and higher yield, and the process is also much, much easier for your operators to understand and control. At the same time, we're normally reducing energy consumption of the laminating process roughly about 50%. So significant energy savings coming also in the same package. And next, we will hear from one of our customers, Glas Gaspelmeier in Austria, about their experiences with the ProWeld technology over the past couple of years.
Mein Name ist Marco Peric. Ich arbeite hier seit 2005 bei der Firma Glas Gaspelmeier in Wagrain in der Verbundsicherheitsglasabteilung. 2018 haben wir die erste Glaston-Laminieranlage in Betrieb genommen. Eine sehr einfach zu bedienende, schnelle Laminieranlage. Seit 2020 haben wir mittlerweile schon die zweite Laminieranlage von der Firma Glaston. Und die dritte große Anlage wurde auch umgebaut auf die Glaston-Anlage. Wir sind momentan in 6-Schicht-Betrieb, produzieren täglich 1600 Quadratmeter Verbundsicherheitsglas. Wir brauchen eigentlich fast gar nichts mit der Hand betätigen, sei es jetzt von der Waschmaschine, vom Lifter, vom Folienauszug, vom Folienüberstand abschneiden. Das funktioniert alles vollautomatisch, spart uns sehr viele Personalkosten, ist qualitativ und von der Geschwindigkeit viel, viel besser. Die Zusammenarbeit mit der Firma Glaston, perfekt organisiert, hilfsbereit, auf unsere Wünsche eingegangen. Hier ist wirklich aufs kleine Detail großer Wert gelegt worden.
Even though we have already done a lot to improve the laminating process and increase the automation level, there are still some steps that we need to take and certain challenges that we need to be able to tackle. And these are happening due to these product variations and production situation variations that we see. So each of your product has its own optimal operating window, and combining these products in a mixed production can be then a bit challenging to the operators. And especially to make things even more complicated, even small variations such as the environmental conditions around the line, like the glass temperature before it enters the furnace, can actually have an effect on the outcome of the process. When we started with our vision of fully automating the laminating process, we started to collect data from our lines. And over the past couple of years, we have been already collecting a huge amount of process parameters, sandwich information, environmental condition information when certain sandwiches have been processed. And of course, first of all, we have been able to educate our customers with the data to provide reports and visualizations about how efficiently their production is running. But also at the same time, we have been analyzing the data in order to being able to complete the loop and bring the process parameters to the line directly from the cloud. And now we're actually getting very close to the phase where we're able to do this. So soon, when our autopilot program is launched, the machine will be able to learn from our cloud data on what is the optimal way of running the line. And what the ProWeld autopilot program will be all about. So it's about increasing the automation level of the line for a growing number of products, so for more and more complex products and more complex production scenarios. And the system will actually be completely dynamic. So the furnace will actually learn to achieve the most optimal processing parameters based on what you are running and where, under which kind of conditions, you're running the glass. And we'll be sharing more news on the progress of the autopilot program still during this year. But now what is available is the autopilot readiness package, which ensures that if you are purchasing a ProL line or a ProL zone upgrade to your existing laminating line, that you have all the necessary hardware in place to take the system into use when it's fully released. And regarding the autopilot program, so if you're interested, let us know at any point. We'll be happy to discuss about this. And now is also a very good time to ask some more questions on this topic. And for that, I will hand it now back to Peter.